All right. Good morning. Rise and shine. Welcome to Morning Glory. This week I'm playing Not a Hero, developed by Roll7, also responsible for Ali Ali. And this was published by Devolver and Team 17 if you're on Xbox. Logan, welcome to the party. Let me know if you can hear me well. The sound is always is key in the first part of the day. Excuse me. Anyway, this is Not a Hero. Like I said, created and produced by Roll7, published by Devolver and Team 17 if you're on Xbox. Released officially last year on like Steam, and then this past winter to all the other platforms. Originally, this game is titled You're Not a Hero. That's You Are Not a Hero. In like 2013. I'm imagining this is like a Flash game. I've never checked it out. Just did a little research to find out some little bits of history about the game. The guy who is responsible for the idea and like the creation of the game is John Ribbons of Roll7. I believe he also is responsible for the idea behind Ali Ali. It said that he had like some sort of list that he created of all these different games that he wanted to produce with like different styles of games, and this combined like three or so of them. I don't know. I'm grabbing all this stuff from all over the internet. This is Not a Hero. Let's dive right into it. It's super, super cool little game. So, that's the premise of the game, is that you're working for Bunny Lord. You're just one of his hired assassins / goons. To answer your question, Logan, have I played this yet? Only a little bit last night, just enough to get a taster for what to expect this week. I try not to play for more than like a half hour the night before. Oh, I'm really a little, clearly just not getting it. This game is really interesting. It is so simple. It's like 2-3 buttons, directional pads. But that's part of the charm of these types of games. Kind of like Enter the Gungeon, you really only have, aside from directional buttons, you really only have like 2 or 3 buttons that you do stuff with. And it really makes these games, I don't know, more challenging and more unique. Oops. Got one of those fuckers. Let's get this guy. Got him. Legendary. Let's go! Training mission nice and easy. Pretty much the whole situation in this game, you're working for this guy named Bunny Lord, who's trying to, he came back from the future from 2048 and is trying to win an election to prevent the world from ultimate devastation. And so you're a hired goon, or number of different goons that are clearing out the crime in the city, as directed by Bunny Lord, who is really freaking hilarious when you listen to the sound effect for his voice, or if you're just reading what he says between missions. He's really, really funny. That's why I was silent for the first one. I thought maybe that would be cute, but yeah, this is just it's a charming, silly, and fun game so far from what I've played. And so this is an indication of everything that comes out of Bunny Lord's mouth throughout the game. It's so ridiculous. So I had unlocked a couple characters last night while playing. Samantha's pretty alright. Each character has like their own little special traits. The other dude I unlocked, I believe his name is Cletus. He has a shotgun. Samantha is all about reloading her gun while she runs. She's got three less bullets than first guy on the list. So the HUD at the bottom there, got your health on the far left, objectives in the center, and then your items on the right. You can have a secondary item, usually a grenade, or type of explosive of some sort or another. One of the tricks of this is like you're supposed to tap the X button to hide behind stuff, but it also makes you slide, and I find that a little bit annoying. Okay, so I'm just basically supposed to go back. There's nothing to be earned here. That's pretty much it. Yeah, I didn't achieve the bottom two. So these are kind of like, those are like secondary missions. You have like one main objective that the game usually puts you through within each day, and then you've got a series of alternate objectives. I don't find them particularly like necessary to beating the rest of it, but it eventually I'm gonna go back and try to beat them all. So Logan just says, the game is really funny, but I remember not really liking the controls. Felt too sloppy for a game like this. I can totally see that. I think some of the charm might be in that simplicity. I'm not entirely sure how far you made it into the game. But like within a half hour to it, I think it was almost exactly a half hour. It might have been about an hour. I had made it up to the seventh day, and that seems like you can really zip through a game like this quickly, which is probably the point. I think like you're meant to go back and like check out areas, redo like missed missions. But yeah, like the simplicity of this game, like with some games, it can be very harmful. Honestly, I feel like this one is one that you just have to grow with. The missions do, in fact, get incredibly challenging later on. I found myself playing certain ones like 4 or 5 times, trying to get them just right, because they start to get really clever. With making you actually have to work for the mission. But yeah, I could see how this would come off as a little bit sloppy, but if you think about it, like, they also did Ali Ali, right? And Ali Ali is, like, a simple side-scrolling skateboarding game. So maybe that's just a thing of the developer. I can't tell if there's anything below me. I don't see myself finishing this one. I guess I'll kill everyone that's finished in time. Yeah, let's get out of here. Yeah, I mean, I think the secondary objectives to try to complete all of them in one sitting, that's got to be incredibly difficult. But Bunny Lord has different dialogue based on who your characters are. So, really, this game has at least 9 different ways you could play it each time, however many characters there are. Well, I guess there are 9. Oops. Sorry, playing around with some stuff I shouldn't be playing with. Okay. Let's get back to it. We're on mission number 3 already. Look at this. This is just flying through. This is what I'm talking about. Like, the training in this game is very quick. So, compared to last week's Mercenary Kings training missions took me the entire first day of streaming. And then I played for an hour after that and still wasn't through the training. Then played an hour the next day, and I believe I'm still in the training missions. So, you get a good split in the 2 different ways you can build the introductory to a small game. I think that zipping through quickly can be good, it can also be bad. Like, I could be missing a lot of information, but really it's too simple a game to be missing much. Which is partially why the training being so short works so well for it. I do hate not knowing why I'm getting knocked back, if it's because of bullets or if it's because I'm getting punched by somebody. That is a little bit frustrating. But critical hits are really fun in the like just running up and just wrecking people. My goal today is maybe to unlock the katana wielding character that I've seen in the previews. I'd love to do that. I love wielding a big sword. I do think, though, like, in the simplicity of this game, that it does offer a really wonderful, like, critical hit, critical destruction type scenario. Oh shoot, I can't get down there. What the heck? Ah, I just died, see? Yeah, so, let's see. Logan says, yeah, that was part of it. Most times I died, I felt like I didn't know why. And Rick says, dude, you would love Broforce. Yeah, I think Broforce will probably be the next new purchase that I look at getting, the next new game that I pick up. I think I'm going to stick to some that I already have for the next couple weeks, but just so I'm not, like, blowing out a ton of money on this PS4 right off the bat. But yeah, this I have not regretted a purchase I've made yet, so it's going to be hard in this show, because I think part of the objective is to try games that I wouldn't be inclined to try someday, so I'm probably going to end up with a few purchases that I'm not too happy with. Yeah, the real trick is, I think, Logan, partially why you might have found it so frustrating not knowing why you died and stuff. Part of that comes down to the fact that you're supposed to be undercover at all times, and there are moments where you just feel like you can't get that cover. Like, I noticed that I thought I was covered and I wasn't. I mean, come on, this character looks so badass. just like running around with a little Matrix trench coat. So this is how you get up there. Not that I need to. I don't even know if I had a grenade. Did I have a grenade? I wasn't looking. Use all the special weapons. Maybe that's what it meant. I'll break out the grenade on the next mission, assuming I get one, Rick. So hope you guys are all having a good start to your week. I had three. Yeah, see, This part of the issue is, like, with fast-paced games, I don't even pay attention to, like, my health. I don't pay attention to my special weapons. Like, I end up missing a lot of stuff. I need to... Hyper Light Drifter is teaching me patience, and then immediately after playing Enter the Gungeon, removed all patience I ever had. Although that game does function better when you take your sweet time and do crowd control. But anyway, this game is not about crowd control. This is a linear run through, just like run and gun kind of game. This mission was really difficult, so I did do this one last night. And this is one of the missions that I was talking about. Like, it's going to take me maybe 5 or 6 tries right now just to get through this. And I personally, I like that. I think from Logan's standpoint, I 100% understand that, you know, if you're not learning why you're dying, then you're not benefiting from the game. But... this game's so fast, I mean, it doesn't feel like it's harmful to, Oh, I'm gonna rip this guy apart from down below. Oh, no, I'm not. Damn it. Got him. So, there's part of the, I'm amazed I even got that. I'd just be lucky if I make it through the rest of this shit. Look at that! One downside to special weapons in this... I just got ripped apart. One downside to weapons in this is that you get the special weapons, and the second you reload, you lose your special weapons. So, I don't know, I feel like maybe this game could benefit from more of a high score style. Where there's actually like a little, I don't know, I'd love to have a little ticker on the top that just tells you like how well you've done in the game. Damn it, running too fast. There we go. So, Logan, I think this game's, like, feel-good vibes come from, feel-good and murdering, comes from when you, land, like, critical hits and stuff, like... Yeah, see, that's what I'm talking about. The neck snap is exactly, like, the stuff that makes this game so cool. But yeah, like, as you get down the line, these secondary missions become so hard to try to get all of them done in one thing. And I don't know how the game stores information regarding that. I love these secondary side characters that are standing next to Bunny Lord each time. And Logan, so I learned something about the origins of this game last night, and to any of my later viewers, something that is really, really neat about the, at least the first version of this game. I think I just picked up on something that kind of plays into this, is Bunny Lord has randomly generated text. Like, some of the things he says, yeah, they're gonna be along the same structure. But each time he says it, it'll be something totally different. And I know they mentioned that was like a thing in the first one, in like the what I imagine to be like the Flash version of the game. So in this one, the way that he talked about children was totally different from the first time I played this. Sneesay's in here. Oh, what up, dude? So I was at Offworld Arcade on Saturday, very, 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 very briefly. I saw you playing Sneesay at the DJ booth. Sorry that I didn't really get a chance to say hi. There were so many people in there. It was almost panic-inducing. But I'd never been to the Checker Bar before. That was my first time actually getting to go. Up here? I wonder how you get up that. Alright, anyway. Yeah, Checker was pretty cool. I did like it. I just,
nailed it.
Yeah, it was just very tightly packed. There's so many people in there. What the hell? I thought I killed his ass. Mission's nice, you're not on a time crunch or anything. That is something that I do wish this game gave me a little bit more of from the start, is just I really like being able to explore. They spend so much time inventing these worlds, like give me a chance to check them out a little bit. This one had some secrets that I noticed I couldn't quite reach, so maybe when I get another character I'll be able to get to it, but... it wasn't a critical? Damn. Oh, so close to completing all of them. Oh well. What'd I miss over here? Rick, I'm sorry, I keep forgetting about my secondary weapons. I can't read the chat while I'm running through this very easily, so I totally missed the boat on it again. Yeah, so I had talked to Aaron about going, and I wanted to go later because I figured, oh, that's when all my friends are going to be down at the Offworld Arcade, but... she was saying, oh, we should just go, you know, right away, right when I got out of work at 6. So, I ended up pushing us to go later, and then it was just not the right decision, I guess. Oh, yeah. Piece of shit. So good. So in this mission, Bunny Lord follows you around. Hey, give me that teleporter, homeboy.
Bunny boy, stop buffing.
All right. I'm gonna pay attention to my power ups this time. That was dumb. Alright, let's try this again. Oh, okay. I can just like slip in this way.
Reload.
Okay, I've got some bombs. Are you ready? Hey, you're not supposed to hit me. Alright, let's just recharge for a second here. Damn it, I hate missing stuff. I miss that freaking keyboard. Oh well. God. Ah. Game is more forgiving with the falling than I'm giving it credit for. Alright, got some grenades. Can't really do much with them. So I killed all the bad guys. Alright, I'll throw one at him. There we go. There you go, Rick. These are my secondaries. Yeah, okay, so my primary objective is to kill that dude, I forgot. Alright, get up to his building. How about that one? That was pretty devastating. Want more artillery? So it's just more artillery. So here we go. Animated cut scene. Hey Greg, welcome to the party.
What do you want? Oh no! Please not the fish! Please no!
Alright, this is where it gets interesting. This is where I died last time. What the hell? Think about what you're doing. For the love of God, I'm a policeman. Put your hands up. Look, I would totally confront these guys, but there are infinite of them, and that's not very pleasant. Let's see what I get. A turret. That's pretty dope. Let's find a good spot for it, though. How about right down here? Oh, there's no escape. Oh, shit. Done. Yeah, so I missed that keyboard and I'm a little pissed about it, but that's okay. Yeah, damn. Six people watching. Thank you for joining in, guys. I'm playing Not a Hero today. Really, really awesome game by Roll7, who also did Ali Ali. Devolver did publish this one. I am a bit of a Devolver junkie now, thanks to the PS4, which is where pretty much all their titles are. I don't want this show to be the Devolver show, so I'm going to try to paste these as much as possible. This game was originally slated for a Vita release that got canceled, which kind of bums me out, but I could see based on how tiny the screen already feels that could be very bad on a tiny screen. This is the mission that I could not get past last night, but I only really checked briefly, so excuse me. Greg says it's hard not to be a Devolver junkie. They put out every good indie game for the past couple of years, and damn if that isn't true. Every game was slated for Vita release and got canceled. It is true, and they're all pretty much Devolver titles. Gungeon was another one that a lot of people were saying, hey, are you going to put this out on Vita? And they said, no, we can't. We'd love to, but the capabilities just aren't there. We just don't have the ability to do this. And what was I playing? Mercenary Kings last week. That one is coming out on Vita, though. So, I mean, you know, whatever. I shouldn't have gotten rid of those explosive rounds. Music in this game is so dope. I have not figured out who the composer is yet. So this mission, I'm blowing up weed plants, if you didn't catch it at the beginning. Grow operation. And I'm in the hood. This looks like my apartment building. Well, I hope you guys are having fun.
You have numbers. Charge that fool.
Over here for you.
What for old boys? I picked up a cat bomb? Yeah, that's right. Okay. That one's a tricky one. I can't get in there yet, so let's go through this. I'll use that in a second, Rick. Just need a proper opportunity. Right now I'm just chilling. Alright, here. How's that? Oh, gun jam? That's dope. It walks around and does whatever it wants until it rips somebody apart. It fully explodes. Alright, let's see. Let's get out of here. Tell me I'm not getting better at this game. Come on down, boys. Through cover, I think I know what that means. Find the wind chime. I never found it. What, did I not get all the plants? Oh, I didn't. Shit. There's one plant thing I missed. Right, let's get these first. We'll get some bullets.
Just say maybe to drugs.
There we go. Just say maybe to drugs. It's true, kids. Just say maybe to drugs. Depends on the drug. If you're not reading this, you're really missing out. Yeah. The sound effects in the coffee shop are really, really quite nice. They when you get your headphones on, it's stupid atmospheric for. Last night I was listening to listening to him talk, and in the background I keep hearing the coffee cups being set down, and somebody doing dishes in the back of the shop, and I kept thinking that my wife is awake and walking down the hallway without me realizing it. This is a dope mission. Alright, let's do it. I hope I get a new character at the end of this. So, gotta save the gnomes. God, ripped apart right at the beginning. Let's do this again.
Mint, let's go.
Alright, guys. We're having a good time here. I fucked that up, but whatever. What the fuck? They shot one of my hostages? Assholes. Now I'm mad. Oh, I can't go back up. Yes, I can.
My blood. You can blow your finger out.
It looks like the gnomes have guns. Why aren't they using them?
Yeah.
That doesn't seem right either. Alright, let's hop over to this other building.
You missed! Hope that stays up.
So Logan, you mentioned that you just didn't care for the controls, but like the more I play this, the more I really enjoy this simplistic controller setup, and I think the dynamic of the game will just get better, not really as time goes on, but more as like, oh shit, how did I get there? More like when you unlock different characters, I feel like it's gonna get better. It's better, for the better that I died. So I think that the more characters you unlock, the more interesting the game can get. Fucking hostages get killed. Sliding felt inaccurate. That's a bunch of characters. Same issues. Huh. I don't know what to say then. Like, this,
A violent today, but a
this
tomorrow.
Game is pretty much, I mean, it's... I'd say it's pretty transparent. There's not much else to it other than what it is. Yeah, that's fair. You just prefer, like, other games like Broforce. I think there's a reason that this game received, like, 8s and 9s in its reviews, and I'm kind of trying to figure out why that is. Because as of right now, I feel like this is a good 7. I could see it being an 8 based on, like, art style and, like, oh, go up there and get that poster done. Based on like art style alone, I think that there's something to be said for like indie games because they have a really nice look to them, and that's a huge selling point. Logan thinks the game is bad.
Hey,
Yeah, Greg, you're right. I mean, you always offer some good philosophical perspective on opinions and things of that nature. I think that is part of the charm of being a part of Detroit Arcade Club, is that we all have such vastly different opinions, and so one game will appeal to like a person like me, will not appeal to a person like Logan. I find it interesting always because we have so much common ground in so many other ways. Indie games look good. Yeah, that's pretty much what I'm saying. Indie games look good. I'm sorry, I'm speaking a little bit more general and hyperbolic than normal because I'm a little distracted by this insane mission. Logan, nobody's trying to say that this game didn't appeal to you. Am I saying that? Am I saying that right now? This show is just like gone way off the deep end today. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Maybe I need to have a few more cups of coffee here. I know it's literally what I said. Dude, don't listen to me right now. I'm just running the stream. Let my actions speak louder than my words. Yeah, we gotta start the leak off with some spice. I guess, Logan, that's really the reason for me doing indies on this stream and trying not to focus on anything else, because there are games like this that, you know, you see and it's just like, oh shit, well, like, artistically that looks like it was fully appeal to me, and then you don't know how it's going to turn out until you actually, you know, purchase the game. So my goal is to be the guy who's purchasing the games and checking it out so that I can give a good, solid opinion on whether this game is worth purchasing. And, I'd have to say this game is so simple. I could see it being a very difficult buy for a lot of people. But the game is also quite short, so it has that as well. I feel like I missed a whole lot. Let's hop on over to the other side of the building. It's getting zesty. Yeah, this game is nice to explore. I wish it wasn't always on the time crunch. So time crunch is purely extra. These mines are useless, by the way. That's why I'm not using them, but I guess I just did. There we go. They're useless unless you're in a pinch. Let's face it, guys, I wasn't gonna finish this in another 150 seconds. It's crazy to think that I could. What do we got over here? Turret? Laser.
You bust the wrong house, man.
A violent today.
Nah, blood.
I guess there's a benefit to being patient in this game.
Reload.
Jesus, I don't know how you could ever finish this in 150 seconds. You'd have to know where every single thing is. Oops.
PR girl extraordinaire. A violent today for a better tomorrow.
A violent today for a better tomorrow. You hear that, guys? Such is life.
Oh,
Oh, I don't see myself getting out of this easily. Where do I go from here? And riddle me this, where's the missing gnome? Hey, we all got time, right? It's only been 45 minutes of the stream so far. Should I go for the specialty weapon over here? Risk dying at the very end? Oh, that took forever to get right. Thank God.
Challenge down.
Fortune favors the bold. Word. There are all these doors that look like they can be opened later on. I'm very curious. Oh, so. Do it up. Poster mortem completed. I really feel like this game could. At this point in the playthrough could benefit from a high score setup. I think that this game really just looks like it is that kind of game. And honestly, I feel like this would also make for a really, really good roguelike. If they did like a sequel where instead of worried about trying to get this, I don't know, I guess the 22-day mission thing works quite well, where you're trying to, you're trying to get votes for Bunny Lord. Could work in a roguelike setup, but I think that this game would really benefit from it. One of the fun little details is after you complete a mission, seeing your character is like super bloodied, just battered as hell when you're at this diner, sitting next to a very clean Bunny Lord. He's introducing a new character that I'm totally ignoring while I talk over him, but whatever. Watch back and reread it or whatever. If you missed it earlier, this game hinges, doesn't hinge. It features a nice little randomly generated text for Bunny Lord. Each time you complete the mission, certain aspects of what he's talking about will change. But it's the same basic message each time. Oh, what's next? Oh, jeez. Oh, I'm gonna fail this mission so many times. Yeah, I'm still gonna fail this mission so many times. Save one hostage, save 10 hostages. It doesn't matter, saving hostages is not my thing. I think I was that kid who always shot the hostages in like the light gun games at the arcades. What was that Police Academy type one? What was that one called? I remember Area 51. So anyway, thank you guys for watching the stream. We still got like at least 10 minutes left of solid stream time. And we're totally going with the Jesus here, the Jesus.
Save the hostages, baby.
Love him already. This guy, I feel like, was like the main advertisement for the game. In all trailers and stuff. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna focus on seeing how to get if possible, how to save these hostages.
Bring it, bitches.
What up? Saved one. Alright, my mission's complete already. Alright, well, where do I go to go up? Do I really have to jump to the other building now? That dude just ripped up that hostage after I'd saved him. Oh no, I saved him. Okay, dope. His specialty kill is really dope. Why the fuck? Can't knock over those big dudes. Just gotta keep that in mind. Alright. Jesus, I was getting blasted all over the place. This is ridiculous.
Thanks.
I can't believe I saved that freaking hostage.
What do you got?
Get to the payphone? Man, that big dude just rips me apart every time.
Time to move.
So where's this payphone, do you guys think? Maybe it's all the way at the end? Maybe just need to like save the one hostage and get to the payphone kind of situation?
What do you got? Found you, gorgeous. What do you got?
I totally fucked that dude up. Whatever. Oh, that's not cool.
What do you got?
What the hell? This character's a little wily. I don't know what's going on, if I'm getting hit by rubber bullets or some shit, but like, I keep flying back.
How did you say?
You bust the wrong house, man. This is a great mission for critical kills. Mission. I don't know if I'm ready to go up.
Murder fool!
Damn, motherfucker! Oh no, I wasted that! Okay, sorry guys, I didn't want to get blown up because there was a fire extinguisher right there. I think if I had stayed there too long, I could have made that really bad. Boy, this mission is really freaking tricky. Got that drill shot.
Thank you.
Damn it, I keep wasting my specialty. I'm too reload happy. Thanks to Enter the Gungeon, I'm very reload happy in general. But this game is. I don't think it's meant to be reload happy. It's very hard not to be. I don't understand this payphone situation, but. Alright, fine. Let's chill out over here. Please tell me, Logan, that fortune also favors the frustrated. Yeah, well, it does not. Well, my cat knows it's almost time to be done streaming because she wants food. Oh, what the hell? I thought I aced you. Ugh, get me out of this mess. Very rarely indeed. Those assholes out of there. Ugh. Really, like, they should tell you that the hardest part of this mission is going to be surviving, but, you know. What, I didn't get either of them? He's got ripped apart again. These big dudes with the machine guns. So you only get 5 hits in this game, or 6? 5. 5 hits in the game. And, a machine gun can take away all those in one fell swoop. Come on. There we go. Critical hit. Every freaking time.
Thank you. Found you, gorgeous. You're gonna babble.
Go right there.
Found you, good looking.
Oh, well, there goes that. So Logan, I think I can totally agree with you that the slide function in this game is rather busted in a lot of ways because it's the only thing that kept me from, well, I guess my own inhibitions, but it's one of the only things that has really been keeping me from being consistent on this specific mission. Look at this. Fucking ridiculous. Oh. Fuck that guy.
You're gonna die.
Am I gonna die? I'm gonna tear you apart. I'm outnumbered. It was 1-1. Oh. Oh, come on, where'd you come from? Did I not kill him? Did you guys see that? Was he there before? Doesn't matter.
Waste me!
You will die! Time to die!
Ugh. Yeah, it is like, it's totally like a 90% situation, but I think because this, like, Roll 7 is mostly known for, oh shit, oh, there goes that hostage. Oh come on, where am I hiding spaces? It's annoying. Okay. Roll 7 is known for Ali Ali, which, is like a very loose, I guess you'd say, Twitch reflex skateboarding game. It's just all side-scrolling, very cool game, but, I guess maybe I should get my hands on it a little bit more, before I start making wild judgments, but, like, I get the vibe that it's probably gonna be very similar to this, in even the same sense that, you know, your reaction time, or, like, pressing the button at a, if the right time isn't necessarily going to benefit you.
I'm running dry.
Like, this game is putting a lot of pressure on you by requiring you to achieve things in a certain amount of times for, I mean, they're secondary missions, so it's not really like it's crucial to the game, but it's putting pressure on you time-wise and then asking you to be patient by hiding behind things and saving your, like, saving your health and, like, recharging your health and stuff. I'd like to check out, Ali Ali in full. I don't think I've really given much of a chance. Side-scrolling skateboarding, it sounded both, appealing and unappealing to me. Man, you just get ripped up right there. Oh, but there's no point in doing anything other than this. Hey, well, we're over the 1 hour marker. I don't know if you guys want me to keep streaming or what, but, I mean, I'll just keep playing until I get this mission done, I guess, at this point.
Thank you so much. Found you, good looking.
Yeah, part of it could be like a learning curve too. I mean, this game, oh shit, I forgot about that fucker. Oh, fucking that dude. There I go. Oh, alright. I've only done this a million times, I should have a good footing for what I'm doing.
Thank you so much. Hey, Gorgeous, found you. Found you.
Time to tag. Waste man.
Why the hell wasn't I not? Oh god. Little gripes. It's the little gripes. All right. Oh, this is clearly the way to handle this. Nope, we will not be doing that yet. Damn it!
It's time to kick some ass.
It's time to kick some ass. Let's do it.
You bust the wrong ass up.
Fucking hell! Fucking die, you pieces of shit. I did save a hostage, right? I'm not crazy. Yeah, I saved that one. Okay, good. Well, fucking shit. I never got that grenade thing to it. Yeah, I guess I got it. Alright, obviously I should be doing it this way. Jesus. Did I get him? Oh, he's still alive up there? That piece of garbage. Piece of human garbage. Alright, that one got him. Alright. All this for a freaking boombox. So it's not really gonna get me anything. As far as I can tell. I guess it's just the thorough nature that I approach games with. Okay, how do we go about this, guys? This is where I get ripped up each time. So that lures him down. No? Come on, dude. Oh God, Jesus. I just want to let my bullets run out so I can get a neck break on one of these guys. They're pissing me off so much. Sweet, sweet neck break. Yeah, I can see why they put those. You know, I think, Logan, it seems like they want you to fuck up the, What the hell? I thought that door would have been closed or something. God, that's so ridiculous. Yeah, they want you to fuck up when you're doing the sliding and stuff. They want it to be challenging. Well, there goes that shit. Asshole. But it's too easy to fuck up, and I think that's where they failed. Like, memorizing how far your slide goes, that's just... God damn.
Hey, found you, darling. Test the pain, darling!
Whatever. I don't know how anybody can make it through this in the amount of time that payphone is still around. Whatever. What the fuck am I doing? Oh yeah, I gotta go up.
You're gonna die.
Reload.
Man, a ladder, a ladder.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about. Satisfactory neck break. And now you're gonna die. Fucking hell. Greg just asked if I was playing Gone Home the other day. Yeah, I was. Last night I played a little bit of it. It is super awesome. I really, really enjoy games like that. I didn't make it. I think I played for like a half hour to an hour. It was one of those like, oh, maybe I should test this out before I stream and maybe I could do this one, but it doesn't fit into the vibe that I'm going for yet. I think maybe I will stream it down the road. It's one of those streams that I think would be difficult to do because it's so story based and I like to talk during my streaming. So maybe I could work on setting up like a nighttime like chill stream. I don't know. Spitballing. I really liked it though. Yeah. a lot.
You got nothing.
It's only 2 to 3 hours long. Let's put the whole game into a week. Yeah, absolutely. And I wouldn't even have to stream off hours, which is cool. Not that that, like... Fuck yeah.
Unstoppable.
This is what I've been needing the whole time, these fat boys. Yeah, I ended up with Gone Home by chance as well. Like I was going through my library on the PS4 like yesterday, day before, and then I realized that I had it, and I think I had. Oh, get me out of this mess! Okay, thank God. I realized that I had it. I must have downloaded it from PlayStation Plus sometime before summer. I can't remember. It went up not that long ago for free. And Chris had kept telling me, "Oh, you should go on the browser and actually download some of those games that you know you're gonna want to play, but you don't have the PS4 right now." So, I didn't realize I could do that, but Chris kept pushing for it, and so with that one, I definitely picked it up as soon as I saw it go up, and it took me by surprise. I like that. Get me out of this mess. That's all I want. That's all I want. Safety and out of this mess. Okay.
Found you.
Okay, my cat is knocking my shit over. Guys, I think I'm just gonna walk out of here. I'm not gonna fuck around with anything else. Did I miss anything else? Whatever.
Okay, time to
hit. Hooray! Finally beat that freaking mission. Oh, Fulbright's the company that made the game. I'd love to see what else they put together. I really, really, really liked it. Aesthetically and, like, story-wise, just all around really interesting game. Thanks, Nessa. Love the support in this group. Oh man, if only I had 6 more viewers right now and we left the messages exactly where they're at, we'd have 6, 6, 6. And that's the way I want to start my week out, every week. Oh, guys, this game is getting harder and harder and harder and harder, and I want to save some of the fun for Friday's stream. So I'm not gonna play through anymore, but I'm gonna be sitting around most of the afternoon today, probably playing a few other games. It's for my chat. Thank you all for joining in today. Logan, I wanted to let you know, might as well tell you while you're on the stream here. Last night I managed to make it to the 4th dungeon in Enter the Gungeon. Do not know how I got so lucky, but those RNG gods graced me in the most beautiful way. I got like this one gun that was, I can't remember what it was called, Devastator maybe? And it was like a homing laser gun, and it just ripped apart enemies. You could fire off like 3 rounds and the bullets would just hover in the room if they didn't kill everybody. So, it's nuts, and I made it to the fourth dungeon and was blown away. So very, very excited last night, but that was immediately before I was like, oh shit, like I should start playing some Not a Hero just to get in some licks. So if any of you guys liked what you saw today, I do suggest checking out the game. There aren't any demos out for it, which is okay. It's only $13, this looks like it's going to have a good amount of replay value, and I think that, fully understanding Logan's feelings on the game, that, like, there's some aspects that mechanically just don't work very well. I think that this is a game that, much like Hyper Light Drifter or Enter the Gungeon or even Mercenary Kings, all games that I've played so far, require a hefty amount of learning to really get that flow just right. And I think this one's going to be no different. I think if I unlock a few more characters, and we'll see by the end of the week, if I unlock a few more characters, if I get the flow down a little bit more on the sliding and not going too nuts with it, that this could be a really, really worthwhile game to pick up. But wait for the end of the week review if you want. Obviously no rush to pick up this game. It's been out since February or so this past year on consoles. So I do want to mention one thing, that if you do decide to get this game, if you're on PlayStation Network, this game is not in any categorized genre for some reason. So don't, if you're going to search for it, use the search bar. Do not go hunting through the different categories. It actually is a little bit upsetting because, I think indie developers already struggle enough with trying to sell their game with so much competition and with the difficulties. Like, I've heard many horror stories about Xbox Arcade Network and then PlayStation Network being a bit of a hassle to deal with. So for them to go through all the effort to make the game and to get it on there, and they're probably hurting for sales because of it. So if you are interested in this game, make sure to use the search engine on the PSN, because you're not going to find it just by going through categories. I did notify Roll7 of this. I haven't heard back from them yet that I'm aware of. But I really hope that I really hope they get that resolved, because I'd hate to see this game go unnoticed by so many people. And it has a really cool graphic. I posted it to the Morning Glory blog yesterday, which is morning-glory-gaming.tumblr.com. We're looking at trying to get a subdomain going for it, but for now, that is the best way to access this show outside of the stream time. I will post the stream sometime later today, and then throughout the week I'll have photos of my notes that I've taken on the game. Although this one, it doesn't seem, I might dabble with like a half hour a day, but not unlike Mercenary Kings, where I was playing almost an hour a day to get a better vibe of what the game was like. This seems a little too short to be pulling that off, so I want to save some good stuff for streaming on Friday. So I don't want to overdo it, though I do really enjoy the look and feel of this game. And I'm bound to get epically frustrated like I was on that last mission. Very, very difficult missions. That's what I live for. That's why I like indie games so much. They retain that old school platforming vibe that, like in Mega Man games, in Super Mario World, you'll die hundreds of times trying to get one stupid thing accomplished. And then when you finally do, it's so gratifying. Anyway, thank you once again for joining us. This has been Morning Glory, and I've been your host, Ben the Fever. Follow Detroit Arcade Club on all of our channels, Twitch, Instagram, Tumblr, Facebook, Twitter, everywhere. We're at Detroit Arcade Club or at Detroit Arcade on Twitter. I guess we'll see you guys on Friday. Have a good week. Bye.